Please welcome to the stage, Mike Wagers. Black and yellow. Yeah.
And yes, before you ask, is there, I'll hold them up, there they are. Now, hope everybody had a great time last night. Hope you're still pumped about downloading the app. Please do so. It tells you everything you need to know about the rest of the day and tomorrow. And importantly, we want to hear from you. We want your feedback on our speakers, on our panels, and on the entire conference. As I mentioned yesterday, that provides us the information we need to put on an even better conference for you at Axon Accelerate 23. Second announcement, if you have not been out in this hallway to my right, to your fun, now we want to inform, we want to educate here at Accelerate, but we also want to make sure you have some downtime and can have fun. In this hallway, we have a retro arcade with pinball machines, Pong, a bunch of stuff. We also brought back, by popular demand, which we heard through our app, Freeze, our ice cream shop, so you can stop by and get ice cream. And I'm not done yet. We also had our Taser versus Zombies VR game. And if you have not played Taser versus Zombies, you have to go before you leave Phoenix and before you leave Accelerate to play Taser versus Zombies. Rick, our founder and CEO, said that he learned more in 30 minutes shooting tasers in VR and blasting zombies than he's done in 30 years shooting real tasers. So I encourage you to go see our hallway of fun, play some games, get some ice cream, and blast some zombies. Now, my job yesterday was to get everyone pumped up for Jocko. I did not do a very good job. I was not a very good hype man, and I don't actually think Jocko needs a hype man, but he had me so nervous when I walked out here, I didn't know what to say. Today, we had the big guy backstage. We're gonna bring up Rick, our founder and CEO. So, I mentioned he's a big guy, he's the founder and CEO. I need everyone to get excited and cheer and put your hands together for Rick Smith.
Hey everyone, welcome to Accelerate. Back in November, I was celebrating us being back together in person for the first time in a very long time. Then, just a few days ago, I tested positive for COVID, which got me thinking. Imagine what this was like 100 years ago during the Spanish flu pandemic. People must have really been stir crazy, confined to their homes with no ability to connect to their friends and family. No Zoom classes, no video meetings, heck, no TV, no telephones, or my kids' greatest nightmare, no iPads. Now, we all complain about too much Zoom, but imagine the past 2 years without it. So, call me an optimist, but there's much to be thankful for how technology allowed us to stay connected during a global pandemic. It has even given me this rather unique way to meet you here via my own personal avatar. Today, I want to tell you a story. It's our story of the roots of Taser and Axon, of how we came to be. Then, we're going to take you on a journey through the ecosystem we have created together and end with some aspirations of where we're going next. My journey here started from tragedy. In December 1990, two of my high school friends were shot and killed only a few miles from here, in what started as an altercation at a red light. They were in their early 20s, barely beginning to figure out life, and in the blink of an eye, three lives were destroyed. Todd and Corey were killed, and the shooter, a businessman with a temper and a gun, is now spending his life in prison. I found it absurd that the self-defense choice in the 20th century was still a bullet, the same tool we've used to kill each other for centuries. Over these same centuries, every other technology has evolved to amazing heights. We shifted from horseback to airplanes and rocket ships, from smoke signals to cell phones. Medicine evolved from leeches and plague masks to antibiotics, vaccines, and even personalized genetics. And yet, we still use the same medieval bullets. The strange thing is, we don't even use bullets for their designated purpose, which is to kill. We only use bullets because they remain the most reliable way to stop a threat. The fact that they kill is a terrible side effect. I envisioned we might be able to invent our way out of this problem with a technology that could stop a threat without ending a life. And as I studied this space, I learned I was far from the first person to have this idea. Science fiction writers like Star Trek's Gene Roddenberry had imagined these devices for decades. And one of the leading engineers of the Apollo moon landing program, a man named Jack Cover, had invented a real-world device called the Taser in the late 1960s, just before I was born. When I learned of Jack's story, I dialed 411, got his number, reached out to ask him whatever happened to his brilliant idea. At the time, he was 73 years old. He was tired and frustrated after decades of effort that had led to two failed companies and his dreams unfulfilled. I was 23, full of hope and enthusiasm for what could be. And together, we formed an odd couple, working together in his garage in Tucson to give the Taser one more try. Together, we created the Air Taser, a flashlight-shaped energy weapon originally built for consumers. We launched the Air Taser in the Sharper Image. Anyone remember that catalog? Well, the Air Taser failed, and I began to understand Jack's frustration. Consumers just didn't believe that this technology worked. If it was so great, they asked, why weren't police using it? So we shifted our focus from consumers to law enforcement. And it turned out that skepticism was right. Our early Taser weapons were buggy and underpowered. They couldn't fully incapacitate individuals who were motivated to fight through the weapon's effects. So we started over with a ground-up redesign focused on finding an electrical waveform that could incapacitate and temporarily paralyze even the most focused person. 6 years after we started in Jack's garage, we ran out of cash. Having driven my parents to the brink of financial ruin for backing this crazy idea, we had no margin left for error. The bills were stacking up, some bills over a year past due, when we launched the new advanced Taser M26 in December 1999. And it was magic. For the first time, there was a less lethal weapon that could drop even the most highly trained and motivated aggressors. And our sales? They skyrocketed. Suddenly, there was enough cash coming in to pay down our debts. And just a year and a half later, we went public on the NASDAQ stock market. After launching the Taser X26, a much smaller device that could fit on your duty belt, our growth went truly exponential. And at one point, we became the top performing stock in the world, recognized by the Wall Street Journal. We founded this company to solve one important problem: to create a viable alternative to the bullet. And we pulled on that thread and discovered a potential solution, the Taser energy weapon. But when you pull on one thread, another one is bound to come loose. As Taser weapons skyrocketed in popularity, we were faced with a new problem. Sensational headlines questioned how police were using Taser weapons. And we realized that the only way to know the truth would be to record it on video. In August 2005, we introduced the Taser Cam. The Taser Cam made great recordings of Taser uses, if you like highlight reels, because you could only see the few seconds right before and right after a Taser discharge. You didn't get any of the context that led up to the situation, and you couldn't know what led the officer to draw the Taser in the first place. So we learned. We adjusted and we moved the camera onto the officer with the Axon Pro, which was designed to be able to capture the full incident, whether or not the Taser was used. There was just one problem with our first Axon camera. We got too carried away, and the camera exploded with complexity and cost. It came in far over budget, and it was so heavy and complicated that officers resisted wearing it. In fact, this was part of a larger problem at the time. Following the successes of the Taser M26 and the X26, I had gotten a bit arrogant. In other words, I had developed Steve Jobs imposter syndrome. I felt like I knew exactly what police really needed, so I could retreat with our engineers, and in secret, we could design amazing products that we could launch in spectacular fashion to surprise and delight our customers. And it wasn't really just the first generation camera. We launched 4 separate products that we'd developed in secrecy without any customer input. There's the first generation Axon camera, the Taser X3, our first multi-shot taser, the Shockwave, that was an area coverage weapon for the military, like a non-lethal Claymore mine, and the X-Rep wireless shotgun round. All these products have one thing in common. They failed, and they failed spectacularly. All 4 have been discontinued. So once again, we found ourselves in pretty deep trouble, and this time it was entirely self-inflicted. I had to do some soul searching and realize that, you know what, I'd never been a cop. I'd never put on body armor and a duty belt, gone out the door wondering in the morning if I would come back to my family that night. And I didn't appreciate how a small design flaw, like the extra 1/2 inch of width on the X3, would cause it to interfere with the functioning of the seatbelt buckle, for an officer had to get in and out of the car dozens of times each day. So coming out of this debacle, we completely re-engineered our product development processes. We introduced a rigorous voice of the customer program, where every product would include in-depth reviews with customers of each and every key detail to get their feedback and ensure that what we were building is what customers actually wanted. The first product to go through this new process would be our second generation camera, the Axon Flex. And as we dug in with customers, we learned that what you valued were simplicity over tech features. The system had to be small, light, rugged, and push button simple. The Axon Flex, it turned our camera business around. But there was an equally important aspect that we also had to address. We had learned from our experience with TaserCam just how difficult it was to deploy software in a police department. Our TaserCam software was a simple application, and we distributed it on a CD-ROM. And yet we discovered that in some agencies, it could take years just to get the IT approvals to install and use even this simple application. I began to understand why officers were telling us that going into work was like stepping into a time machine with badly outdated technology that felt decades behind the tech you had in your pockets as a consumer. And not only were these systems complicated and slow moving, many of these systems ended up as data silos, where information would sit isolated in one system, largely unusable to the users across the agency. And the more we dug in, the more clear the solution became. We could leverage the cloud to deliver not only our software, but to store, secure, manage, analyze, and share all forms of digital information and digital evidence content. Some of you may know this, but the reason we selected the name Axon for our camera was because axons are the long nerve fibers that connect our brains to our eyes, ears, and muscles. We felt that the connectivity of our cameras would be their single most important feature. And as our cloud ecosystem came together, we envisioned a triad connecting hardware, software, and people. It's this connection to people that's ultimately the most important. Because if videos and photos sit on a CD somewhere in a file folder, they're useless until somebody gets those disks and puts them to use. Technology only matters when it comes in contact with a human. There was just one problem. Our customers were telling us they didn't want to wear body cameras, and they didn't want to use the cloud. Customers told us that the cloud wasn't secure enough, didn't seem reliable enough, and some even said it was illegal for them to put evidence into this cloud thing. We were losing money hand over fist. Developing cloud software was extremely expensive, and sales were struggling. At one company meeting in 2013, the number one question I got was, when would we consider shutting down the video and cloud business? Well, here was my answer. I put up an image of Cortez burning his ships. There would be no going back. As George Patton might say, there's no going back. The only path is forward. I had come to believe that video would not only become accepted, it would one day become the standard. And the cloud? Look, from a pure technology perspective, it is far more secure and reliable than a server sitting somewhere in a closet. I'm glad we stuck with it. Because in 2014, after Officer Darren Wilson fatally shot Michael Brown, the world changed. And body cameras went mainstream. There was no police officer who wanted to go on patrol without the protection of a camera. And the public demanded it. Now, I have learned the dangers of hubris, that we must listen to the customer and we must design products together. But sometimes an outsider can see where things are going and where change needs to happen. And so while I will never have further delusions that I'm Steve Jobs, I do believe I can be a good thought partner to help connect your challenges to what technology can make possible. The theme of this year's Axon Accelerate is common threads. Everyone sitting in the audience today is connected, whether you've met or not. You're connected by a shared mission of public safety. And no matter what segment of public safety you work in, whether you are a corrections officer or an EMT or a prosecutor, each of your work connects to the work of everyone around you. I started today by sharing our history to help everyone understand how we got here, to today, where we have developed an ecosystem of such breadth that it's sometimes hard for me to wrap my head around it. And this is my job, it's what I do every day. So I can only imagine how difficult it must be for you to keep track of everything in this wide-ranging ecosystem. So now, I'd like to take you on a tour through today's Axon ecosystem, and to do that, I'd like to invite to the stage our Chief Revenue Officer, Josh Isner. Josh?
No, I'm going to do this in person. It's nice to see everybody this morning. What you see on the stage there, and I think what you see behind me up here, is our early prototype of the avatar. Now, back in maybe 2016 or 2017, Rick had this idea. He was on the road a lot. He was traveling more and more. He said, hey, I want to, you know, check to see what everyone's doing at headquarters. It'd be nice to check in and go throughout the building and, you know, talk to people throughout the day. So we had a similar setup walking around our headquarters with the avatar on. So after thoroughly creeping everyone out for about 6 months, Rick wanted to take it on the road. And so Rick wanted to go to customer meetings, and a few of us in sales were a little lukewarm on that idea. And so we agreed we were going to test it at a meeting with a financial analyst and one of our investors out in San Francisco. So we all travel out to San Francisco with the avatar. Meeting goes okay, you know, there's some technical glitches, but we're getting through it. Rick's answering the questions. And then at the end of the meeting, everyone stands up to shake hands, and the avatar puts his hand up at like eye level. And it was at that moment when I realized the avatar could not see a thing. And so, shake hands, awkward handshake, avatar turns around, walks directly into the wall. Down goes the avatar. In all seriousness, one of the most inspiring things about working with Rick is the fact that he can skate to where the puck is going. He envisioned a need for this technology, and it's the reason that on a couple days' notice, we're able to carry on with our keynote as originally planned. That type of innovation is one of the things that I've enjoyed most about working at Axon over the last 13 years. And it's been an honor working with you, and truly inspiring to see the sacrifices that you all make to better your communities. I hope to spend the entirety of my career helping to make your lives better and safer. And over this next segment, I'm going to give you a warp speed tour of the Axon ecosystem. Quick disclaimer before we start, we're going to cover a lot of ground in a short amount of time. So please don't feel like you need to remember everything that you hear about. If specific concepts or products catch your eye, we'll be happy to go deeper with you one-on-one at some point this week. But I'm going to start the tour with what we call the Officer Safety Plan, or the OSP. OSP began at a meeting with the Los Angeles Police Department when the then CIO Maggie Goodrich, Sergeant Dan Gomez at the time, asked us if we could bundle our offerings into one simple contract. A great description of OSP came from the Louisiana State Police. They said the Officer Safety Plan is like boarding a train into the future, because with OSP, agencies receive continuous software upgrades along with new body cameras every 2.5 years and a new taser every 5 years. Basically, it gives agencies the ability to continually modernize your technology. So let's walk through what's included in the OSP 7 Plus Premium Plan. It's our top and most popular program. And it all starts with the Taser, our most well-known product. The OSP includes the new Taser 7, and as I mentioned earlier, with this offering, agencies get a new Taser every 5 years. Many agencies are actually now signing up for 10-year programs, so they know they'll be able to upgrade to our next generation of Taser at a known fixed price. Additionally, every OSP customer receives our Axon body cameras. We provide each user with the latest model of Axon BWCs to ensure that critical evidence is always captured. As I said, body-worn cameras are replaced for every user every 2.5 years, and every device is connected to Axon evidence. Early on, we realized that the only way we could rapidly deploy hundreds of thousands of body cameras across the world would be to create a cloud-based DEM solution so that you could properly store, manage, and securely share all of your digital evidence. That solution is now Axon Evidence, which you all may know as evidence.com. With Taser weapons, our mission is to protect life. With body cameras in the cloud, our mission is to protect truth. However, the world at large, and especially the media, are full of skeptics. When a camera is turned off, it's easy for people to believe in conspiracies, to assume the worst. So it's not just about protecting truth, it's about protecting trust. We've seen what happens when a critical incident is not recorded, and we want to do everything we can so that you never miss a moment. Enter Axon Signal. Signal is our technology to ensure that in high-stress events, officers' cameras, both body-worn and otherwise, are automatically activated. Signal Sidearm is a holster attachment that detects when the sidearm has been drawn and sends a wireless signal to ensure the camera is recording. Taser 7 also emits an activation signal when armed, as does the Fleet Signal, which is a sensor installed in the vehicle, activating on a variety of actions from turning on the light bar to opening the car doors. And then there's CAD activation, which is a new feature. When you integrate your existing CAD system with Axon, you can automatically activate your AB3 the moment an officer is assigned to a call. And with geofences, you can ensure that cameras arriving to the scene of a high severity event are also automatically activated. And whether via automatic or manual activation, to ensure this policy is being followed, we need safeguards in place to help with compliance. That's where Axon Performance comes in. It allows agencies to see your camera activation rates down to the squad level. From there, performance audit tools incentivize policy compliance. For example, Performance includes a hot streaks feature, which sends an officer kudos when they consistently activate their cameras to capture calls for service. And I know you may be wondering, does performance actually influence compliance with the camera policy? We found the answer is a resounding yes. In the first year of using Axon Performance, Hillsborough County Sheriff's Office in Florida saw their body-worn camera rates increase from 46% to 81%. So we have all these safeguards in place to ensure the camera is turned on to record mode. But if Murphy's Law is present, anywhere in the world, it's in public safety. So this past year, we introduced our strongest fail-safe yet. It's video recall, which ensures agencies can access digital evidence even if your camera wasn't actually activated. When enabled, video recall can preserve up to 18 hours of video in an encrypted extended buffer. This video buffer does not upload to Axon Evidence unless someone with the correct permissions physically takes the device to perform an investigation. Video recall allows you to securely recover an incident that was never actually recorded in the first place, a moment otherwise that would have been lost forever. When we put all of these pieces together, reliable, easy-to-use cameras, informed policy with performance oversight, automated signal activation, and a final fail-safe, we will truly never miss a moment. And we can help protect trust with the communities who have come to expect there will be video of all critical incidents. But capturing video is really only a piece of the equation. Let's talk more about the products in OSP that help you actually review and use this video evidence. First, Multicam Sync checks if other Axon cameras were on at the scene of the incident. If so, in Axon Evidence, you will see an indication that the other cameras were on the scene, and our software will actually allow you to watch four feeds simultaneously. Third-party video playback. This is a new one for us. We acquired the technology leader in this category, InputAce. Now you can play back thousands of different formats natively right in Axon Evidence. In our top tier, the OSP 7 Plus Premium plan, we include unlimited data storage for all of your digital evidence, including CCTV and other third-party sources. You can truly back the truck up. Built from the ground up to be forensically sound, Axon Investigate is a new capability from InputAce. It allows any user in the agency to analyze, narrate, and share court evidence faster than ever. There's also Redaction Studio, which allows you to easily redact video as you watch it. It includes object tracking technology to greatly speed up redaction times. In addition to these powerful capabilities in our cloud software, we also have a suite of mobile applications to help you manage and share your digital evidence in the field. There's Axon View, which allows you to view live video from your body camera on your phone, watch instant playback of captured evidence, and search and tag all of your evidence from your mobile device. There's Axon Capture, which allows you to record video, audio, and video evidence from your phone that is automatically tagged with the GPS locations and metadata and uploaded to evidence.com. Citizen allows you to easily collect digital evidence from citizens and businesses. Just send a link by text or email, and the recipient can directly upload photos and videos to the case that you specify. No more sending an officer with a thumb drive or a CD, putting the chain of custody at risk. Citizen for Communities, likewise, allows you to send out a public link via Twitter or another platform, a critical capability for major crimes where you need to quickly gather evidence from civilians and the public at large. Think how this could have made a difference in the tragic Boston Marathon bombings. Managing hundreds or thousands of devices is really hard. We hear that all the time from our customers, especially when they need to be reassigned to different users day to day. Axon Device Manager allows you to register, assign, and reassign hardware from your mobile device. No more paper lists with thousands and thousands of cartridge serial numbers. Up until this point, we've talked about the tools necessary to run an efficient, but relatively basic body-worn camera program. Now it's time to get into the next-gen software that our team has built from the ground up. Respond is our real-time communications platform that allows authorized users to view officer locations on a map using GPS locations from AB3 and Fleet 3 and Axon Air-powered drones. This lets you know exactly where to send backup or emergency services. Axon Respond also allows users to live stream from all Axon devices when the situation demands it, and it alerts those wearing an AB3 that the live stream is actually being watched. Transcription allows for fast evidence review by allowing agencies to use keyword searches to scrub video for specific key moments. A new time savings calculator shows how transcription speeds up the time it takes to review digital evidence. Currently, transcription can result in a 36% time savings during evidence review. Think about what your staff could do with 36% more time. Soon, we will be releasing a new update that will increase transcription speed and accuracy further. All files will be transcribed in under 5 minutes, and transcriptions will be more accurate, especially in regards to transcribing various accents. Transcription also includes priority-ranked video audit in performance, helping supervisors find the most relevant videos for review. We are currently using our transcription software to create a dictation feature in records. This feature allows users to dictate records rather than manually typing them out. We believe this is a game changer in terms of efficiency. Speaking of Axon records, we are pumped to talk about our next generation records management system. You've been hearing about it for a few accelerates now, and at this point, we've had a much improved user interface and easy case sharing. But the true magic of this product is putting digital evidence at the heart of the record. After all, if the evidence tells the story, why require cumbersome, antiquated processes that essentially isolate a written report from the rest of the case? We believe we have solved this problem, and just a few weeks ago, our friends down south in Tucson, Arizona, went live. That brings us to 3 live major cities with several others in the queue. And if you're looking for a way to experience Axon Records before committing to the entire product, try our first module called Axon Standards. Standards is a report writing, routing, and management system that agencies use to reduce paperwork and time spent on administrative tasks. Agencies use standards to handle use of force reporting, along with more than 15 other types of reports, from officer pursuit and crash forms to early intervention and field training operations reports. As you can tell, we're pretty excited about the officer safety plan. However, regardless of what products and features are included, it's our job to make sure everyone is well trained on how to actually use them. So we have equipped OSP with the following key training products and services. First, Axon Academy is the backbone of our training platform. It's an e-learning system that provides foundational knowledge, content, and certification management. Axon Academy integrates across our offerings from in-person training events to online content to our new VR training capabilities. Also included in OSP is TASER training. Every year we train thousands of instructors through online and in-person training events. We hope to see you all at TaserCon, our largest ever TASER training event. It'll take place in Las Vegas in January of 2023. In addition to in-person training, we're going all in on VR. First, VR community engagement training is our foundational VR training that's been in the field at over 1,100 police agencies. Community engagement training uses carefully designed scenarios with human actors, allowing officers to make decisions in virtual reality and watch how their scenarios unfold based on their choices in these very human scenarios, building empathy and understanding. Second, VR simulator training is the newest and most exciting element of our VR platform, which allows officers to actually engage in VR for the first time. We intentionally designed the simulator to be as true to life as possible using physical devices such as your Taser 7 loaded with VR cartridges and an inert Glock weapon. And the beauty of VR is its scalability. VR simulator training is portable and mobile. It can be used anytime, anywhere. It doesn't require dedicated training space, and agencies don't have to have trainees travel off-site to perform their in-service training. Trainees can instead grab a headset and a VR kit anytime, and they are constantly reinforcing their learnings. We have consistently heard that training can be cumbersome and expensive. We've heard that a lot. And VR can really help solve that problem. Along with our training offerings, we support our customers and communities in two additional ways. Axon Aid is our philanthropic arm of Axon. Aid provides no-cost mental health and disaster response resources to agencies and communities in your time of need. We have offered PPE during the pandemic as part of our Got You Covered drive, drone services during disaster recovery, and financial support to the families of fallen officers. And our community impact team is focused on helping our customers engage with their communities, educating them about key public safety technologies, and building community support for products that can protect life. To recap, everything we discussed, every product and every offering you see on the screen right now is included in the OSP 7 Plus Premium. OSP ensures your agency, regardless of size, can be on the cutting edge of public safety technology, and that can really help with recruiting. In a talk with the City Council in December 2021, the Chief of Rochester Police Department had a great quote. He said, "At this point, we're not interviewing candidates. The candidates are interviewing us. In order to attract and retain the best top young talent, we have to provide them with cutting-edge technology to do their job." We designed OSP to include all of the tools and software that would benefit each officer on the street. Now, we talked a lot about OSP, but we also have offerings that didn't quite fit into this model, either because they would be purchased for a different set of users, or maybe because they would be assigned to a vehicle instead of an individual police officer. So let's go over the systems that are outside of the officer safety plan. First, Dispatch is our disruptive CAD software built in the cloud with a modern interface and integrated with the full Axon ecosystem. We just went live with our first major city, so we expect to spend plus or minus about 6 months really tuning the system as we learn together with our customer. Justice is a new category designed to help courts process digital evidence more effectively and ensure justice is served in a timely manner. Axon Attorney Premier is our first justice product. It helps by providing a discovery module that assists criminal lawyers on both sides so they know that at a glance what evidence they have, where it came from, what is new, what has been shared, and what shouldn't be shared, and thus improving efficiency for prosecutors and defense attorneys alike. Interview Room is a cloud-based system that streamlines your interview process by giving you the ability to bookmark, annotate, and comment on interview footage in real time. It integrates directly with evidence.com so that all of your evidence is truly in one place. Fleet 3 is our latest in-car camera system that includes automated our model by leveraging AI to reduce cost, making it affordable for police departments to deploy ALPR running in every single car. The entire Fleet 3 offering, including ALPR, costs less than a basic in-car camera video system from our competitors. As we built out Fleet 3, we learned that our customers also wanted to have a compatible fixed ALPR system as opposed to the one in the vehicles, which is mobile. So, and we found a partner that was a perfect fit. That partner was Flock Safety. Flock has the industry's leading fixed ALPR platform. It is completely self-contained with its own solar power and LTE connectivity. And Flock cameras don't just read license plate. They provide the world's first vehicle fingerprint technology to identify color, make, model, and unique features of suspect vehicle, allowing police to track leads and ultimately solve crimes. In some cities, the presence of Flock Safety has contributed to a The partnership makes it easier and more cost-effective for agencies to deploy a network of both fixed and mobile ALPR capabilities. And recently, Flock introduced Raven, their gunshot detection module that offers a more cost-effective way for agencies to monitor their communities for gunshots. Flock was really a watershed moment for us. This is when we realized that we could help our customers by working with complementary partners to integrate their solutions into the Axon ecosystem. Axon is not going to be the industry leader in every technology. So we strategically partner with companies to fill gaps in our ecosystem and solve customer needs for you all. Perhaps the biggest change to the Axon ecosystem in the last 12 months or so has been our extensive growth of capabilities through partnerships. Now, we're going to talk about a few more partnerships, starting with Axon Air. It's our drone offering that works seamlessly with some of the most promising companies in this space. There are few technologies that hold more promise to advance our goal of protecting life than drones. Axon Air, powered by DroneSense, is a comprehensive platform that securely manages piloting, live streaming, and program management, and integrates seamlessly with Axon Respond and Axon Evidence. It provides a best-in-class experience for drones that are flown manually at the scene of an incident that enables drones as a first responder, which is commonly known as DFR. DFR will fundamentally change how public safety responds to emergencies by accelerating response times, serving as a force multiplier, and improving situational awareness to ultimately save lives. Chula Vista, actually, one of my early customers, was one of the leaders in this DFR concept, and I think Chief Kennedy is here today, so I just wanted to say thank you for your leadership in this space. Additionally, we have partnered with three leading drone companies. Skydio is the leading U.S. provider of drones and the market leader in autonomous flight and 3D scene capture. DJI is the global leader in consumer and enterprise drones, and PhotoKite is a unique solution for continuous and autonomous flight through a tethered drone that can launch right from the top of a vehicle. Axon is a reseller and software integrator of all three of these partners. And finally, there's Dedrone. As drones become more common in our skies and across our communities, they pose tremendous new benefits, but also new threats. Whether they're accidentally flown into restricted airspace by a recreational pilot, or worse, with malicious intent by a bad actor, they're a threat to our airports, critical infrastructure, and communities must take steps to mitigate these risks. Axon did an extensive review of all the companies in this space, and we selected Dedrone as the leader in drone detection and mitigation to be our partner. Dedrone's sensor technology can cover specific infrastructure, or even blanket an entire city with a bubble of drone protection using radio frequency detection, radar, and AI-enabled camera systems. We're working with Dedrone right now to make their solution a core component of our real-time operations offering. I was particularly excited to see Dedrone's new mobile solution, a simple trailer that sets up in minutes and can provide a one-mile bubble of coverage for special events. We might use this next year at the Waste Management Phoenix Open, hosted right here in Scottsdale. In addition to our drone partners, our Verizon partnership brings increased connectivity to public safety for the benefit of first responders in the communities that you all serve. AB3 cameras connect securely on Verizon's network to provide critical data communication to services to Axon customers across the U.S. And likewise, we've partnered with FirstNet. AB3 passed carrier certification on FirstNet, the only nationwide high-speed broadband communications platform dedicated to and purpose-built for America's first responders in 2019. Another one of our infrastructure partners, Cradlepoint, offers hardened routers that create a high-reliability Wi-Fi network in the car, creating a secure means for officers to connect and offload evidence to Axon evidence directly from their vehicle, enabling Fleet 3's ALPR live streaming and seamless communication abilities. Cradlepoint works with multiple carriers and can support 4G LTE and 5G data connectivity. Now, our longest standing partner, Microsoft, provides Axon evidence with the storage, processing, and scaling partner of the cloud. Axon uses Azure geolocations around the world to help agencies comply with local data sovereignty regulations, demonstrate end-to-end data control, and guarantee that video evidence is in fact genuine. Celebrite streamlines investigative workflows and shortens time to justice. Through this partnership, data collected, analyzed, and reviewed by Celebrite's digital evidence platform will now integrate seamlessly with Axon evidence to provide law enforcement with one place to manage, review, and safeguard all of your digital evidence. And lastly, I'm excited to talk about our newest partner, Fusus, which is the market leader in real-time crime center software platforms for public safety. Today, Fusus has enabled a public-private crime mitigation network where private camera owners, from small businesses to large retailers, and from healthcare systems to educational institutions, can voluntarily provide agencies access to their camera feeds to better support community-based policing efforts. Simply put, Fusus can be the hub of all of the live streams across your jurisdiction, maximizing situational awareness. So who can repeat all that back to me? I know it's a lot to cover. The hope is that you picked up one or two products along the way that you can take back to your agency to enable safer resolutions, greater efficiency, and more defined outcomes. And before we close this tour, I'd like to announce one more brand new, fun, and incredibly rewarding project that we are just rolling out. It's called Axon Studios. We live in a connected world where people learn and form opinions based on what they see online. Unfortunately, social media and news networks have a strong incentive to showcase the most controversial content and edit it in ways that grab people's attention. If it enrages, it engages. We think it's important to have a more balanced approach to easily share the stories of public safety with your communities in a way that helps them see and understand all of the work you are doing day in and day out to protect life. And so we thought, what if we create a production studio to build a streaming service for public safety? A platform that focuses on creating and sharing stories of heroism and humanity from public safety, and a place where difficult situations can be explained alongside meaningful context. Today, we're excited to unveil the First Responders Network. Let's play the trailer.
We put the uniform on, we risk our lives every night.
Go left onto 2nd Street, but bail out.
Let me borrow your bike, man. Radio, we got it.
You're going to the fire. Here, I got you. Hold on.
Oh, God. Come on, Nick. Oh, God.
The First
first, I didn't think he was going to run.
Stop!
So today, you're witnessing history, because the First Responders Network is streaming content for the first time ever right now. And if you're watching this from home, this is our first live broadcast. That's right, this keynote is streaming live on FRN at this moment. We're excited about the light that FRN will shine on the amazing work that you all are doing. We believe this platform will serve an important purpose to help rebuild trust through authentic stories and meaningful conversation, not vitriolic rhetoric and incendiary headlines. Media content holds power, and photos and videos have the power to affect the public, to let them see the reality of your jobs, the reality of the condition of the world, and the reality of the sacrifices you make to serve every day. If you're interested in your agency being featured on the First Responders Network, our Axon Studios team is set up on floor 2, right downstairs, all week to talk with you about your media needs and how we can best serve you. And please feel free to visit the FRN app by simply scanning the QR code that you see on the screen behind me, or you can download it directly from the App Store or from Google Play. So that's the Axon ecosystem. It's a collaboration leveraging connected technology to make our world a safer place. Thank you so much for indulging me. And at this point, I'd like to bring Rick back on, in avatar form, to end on our moonshot goal. Thanks very much.
Let's give it up for Josh, everybody. Last time I was on this stage, in my other body, at Accelerate 21, I announced our moonshot goal to reduce officer-involved shootings by 50% over the next decade. Moonshot has become a phrase to describe inspirational goals that may seem impossible, but are scientifically possible. Like JFK's 1962 declaration of the goal to put American astronauts on the moon before the end of the decade. So I'd like to give you a little more detail on our roadmap, the science of how we can work together to achieve our moonshot. We've spent the past several months analyzing the Washington Post database of over 1,000 fatal officer-involved shootings in 2021. Our analysis shows that we could potentially avoid up to 90% of fatal officer-involved shootings through a combination of more effective and longer-range handheld taser weapons and the use of drones and robotics. Now, we know the idea of using drones and robots to incapacitate dangerous people will be controversial, but that doesn't scare us off. Controversy is what we do. Tasers were controversial. Now they save lives. Body cameras were controversial. Now they save careers. The most impactful technologies in this space will always be controversial. But that's also part of the reason why we've introduced our ethical framework, our three laws of first responder robotics. Years before the technology is ready for the field, we are already having important conversations about the safety controls and regulations needed to avoid misuse, so you can save lives with this technology. In addition to stronger tools like advanced taser weapons and robotics, better training will help give officers new skills and help adapt to leverage these new technologies. Virtual reality will play a key role, allowing officers the ability to practice with taser weapons and other tools in ever more realistic scenarios, learning new de-escalation skills and improving their performance. And then the final piece of the puzzle is we will need better data. Data is the key to solving any problem. You first need to be able to measure the problem effectively so you can measure your progress. To support our moonshot, we're announcing a new initiative called Fathom. We chose the name Fathom because it means to penetrate the truth of something, to understand it deeply. We often hear it in the negative context. I can't fathom why she did that. Well, we're going to help the world fathom what's happening in these most critical law enforcement encounters. Now, Fathom is not a product. It's a framework for evidence-based response to resistance reporting. We chose the term response to resistance over use of force because we believe that use of force only happens in a small percentage of cases that start with subject resistance. Response to resistance reporting will track both successful de-escalations and the use of force when it does occur. We have spent years working with legal, medical, and evidence-based policing experts to design a system that will allow us to better understand the impact of new tools and tactics in policing and to answer these key questions. How often do officers successfully de-escalate? What is the impact of new tools or training on de-escalation, on injuries to both police officers and subjects? And how effective are these new systems at gaining compliance? Just as importantly, Fathom will help us understand what causes failures of taser weapons and other tools in the field so we can design them to perform ever better. And finally, Fathom is being designed to help answer the key question in many communities: are officers treating people equitably? It's my belief that today's systems don't effectively answer that question, and they may even create misleading data that exacerbates tensions between police and their communities. We'll be looking for agencies who are open to changing the way you track force and resistance. It's not fully live yet, but if you're interested, please send an email to fathom@axon.com, and we will reach out to you as Fathom progresses later this year. 30 years ago, I lost two friends to gun violence, and I discovered an issue that has to be solved: our reliance on lethality for protection. That led me to found this company with a mission to protect life. In the 3 decades that have followed, we have worked with countless members of public safety, subject matter experts, and researchers to investigate each problem we have discovered together, all in the hope that the solutions we create together will help us towards that ultimate North Star. Today, we've outlined our progress to date with some new capabilities to ensure that you never miss a moment. Our new platform to help you tell your stories through the First Responder Network, and our moonshot goal, that together we will reduce fatal officer involved shootings. For the problems we identified together. For better or worse, we are forever connected to one another. We are bound to support one another in our mission to protect life. Over the next decade, we will fail or succeed as one. And I personally cannot wait to take on that challenge with all of you. Thank you for what you do. Thank you for allowing us to be part of your team. Our society safe for all of us.
Thank you to Josh and also to Robo Rick. As I said earlier, backstage, that could have gone really bad or it was going to really work out. So I hope you guys were entertained by Rick being the avatar. Now, we are super passionate and we are committed to this moonshot goal. It's driving all of us internally at Axon to reduce, help you guys also are passionate about voice of the customer. So we have these limited edition challenge coins for our moonshot goal. If you would like one and you would like to talk about the moonshot goal or anything else that Rick talked about up here on stage, our team will be down below. We'll pass these coins out, or you can catch me throughout the rest of the conference. So now we're going to take a break for 30 minutes. The breakout sessions start at 10:30 downstairs on level 2, and then we'll reconvene back in this room for lunch at 11:30. Thank you. Bye.